broadcasting across the nation and around the world. It's the
Not So
Late Show with
Brandon Love.
Tonight, Stella Donnelly.
And now, with the power of a straight eight engine,
Brandon Love.
All right.
I love that.
Yeah, I put a lot of effort into this. All right, welcome everybody back to the Not So Late Show. I'm your host, Brandon Love, and we have the wonderful Stella Donnelly on tonight's show.
Hi, Brendan. Nice to be here.
Thank you for being so accommodating. We're coming live from Stella's abode in Melbourne. Why are you in Melbourne?
Well, I'm crashing here at the moment.
Yeah, why are you in Melbourne?
I'm doing a couple of things. I was just at something called the Seed Fund, which was a management workshop out in Woodend.
Boring!
I know, I'm really living my best life right now. Yeah. But then I'm playing a show at the Athenaeum. Is that how I've been calling it? The Athenaeum.
Wednesday night with John Butler.
With John Butler and Casey Chambers. So that should be nice. That'll be beautiful.
Is that like a sort of a... Is that like a gig slash kind of songwritery talk
thing?
It's
kind of like a songwriter's in the round. So there might be a couple of guest spots.
Okay.
You know, I might be singing on a couple of John's songs and, you know, doing that sort of thing. So it should be a really nice evening.
I love that man.
He's fantastic.
Out of all of those people I grew up kind of idolizing as a young guitarist.
Yes.
He was the one that when I met, you know, when they like don't meet heroes kind of thing.
Totally.
I met him and I was like, oh, he's like, he's just so cool.
He's beautiful.
He's
a beautiful man.
Yeah. He's good to hang out with.
Yeah.
But before we get too far into this, we should, give our viewers a little bit of background on one Stella Donnelly. So normally I like to tell a little story about the guests.
Yep.
So, let me tell you a story. So, Stella Donnelly was raised between Morriston, Swansea, did I say that right?
Morriston, close enough.
Whatever. Swansea in Wales and the burbs of Quinns Rocks, Western Australia. She got her start singing Green Day songs in her high school band, eventually turning her interests to jazz and contemporary. As an adult studying at the West Australian Academy of Performing Arts...
I dropped out.
I was just about to do a soliloquy and be like, she dropped out after a year.
I dropped out. I don't even know why that's in my bio. Absolute bullshit.
Well, it's like just credibility.
Couldn't hack it.
The highfalutin, you know, like, well, I studied jazz.
Fucking barely.
Anyway, let me finish, all
Sorry.
Right? At the beginning of 2017, Stella released her debut EP, Thrush Metal, and was met with critical acclaim, written over 2 years, the bold and unapologetic repertoire of songs forged Donnelly to the forefront of the new guard of Australian songwriters. Her debut album, Beware the Dogs, also came out in 2019, and was one of my top picks for 2019.
Thank you. It's a year ago today that record came out.
Well, so. Do you want to know something even more interesting? It was 2 years ago today that we first met.
Whoa.
At Port Fairy Folk Festival.
There you go.
It was the first time I saw you play.
And I thought that Brendan was in the Pierce Brothers, a completely different band.
That's easy to get wrong, you know.
I know,
Our last names are both brothers.
Yeah, that's it.
Hang on, wait, I got an... That doesn't stop unless I turn it off. But check this out. Here is a video from the first time we met.
Oh my God.
Remember that?
There's the Black Rock Band t-shirt. I'm still just as stupidly awkward. Oh, God, kill me.
Anyway.
God.
Yeah, so that was... You had just played on one of the stages.
Yes.
And I'm always late to the party on everything. Everything. I'm always the guy that's like, have you guys heard of this guy called, like, Bon Iver? And everyone's like, you're an idiot. Have you guys watched Breaking Bad? Anyway.
Amazing.
Yeah, I'm always late to the party, so I saw you for the first time at that, at Port Fairy, and then I was like, I must go meet this person. And then I did, and then, yeah, I think you were like, oh, yeah, you're in that Pierce Brothers band.
Quickly, just going on what you just said about, you know, have you guys seen this or whatever? The other day we were driving past the airport in the tour van and my guitarist, Jack, we saw like a house that was near the airport. And Jack from my band really innocently was just like, They should make a movie about like a family that lives like under the airport, under an airstrip. They really should. Like, yeah, that'd be a really funny Australian movie.
Yeah.
And all of us in the band are like, are you kidding me? Are you yeah, kidding me? There's yeah, a movie called The Castle, by the way, for anyone.
Yeah, for any international viewers, yeah, if you want to get a sense of Australia, watch a movie called The Castle. She'll say The Castle. I'll say The Castle.
The Castle.
What do you call this on the table, Stella?
A plant.
Bloody, bloody da, mate. All right. Yes. What was I going to say? I want to get to... No, that's all right. I don't know what I'm ever going to do on here anyway. I want to get to... So you come out with this EP, which I was late to the party on. I see you perform, and then I go back and listen to the EP. And then I'm like, yeah, okay, I get it. I get it. I get this. I get why this is a thing. And then in between that time, you start... Well, you're touring and being busy and blah, 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 blah. But then you start work on the album. And I'm interested to know about the transition from playing and touring the EP to then recording, writing with a band and releasing the album, Beware of the Dogs. Because I remember we caught up in London.
We did. We were in Newcastle, actually.
Were we?
There you go. Up in the north.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. And that was, I think you were talking about, you were just starting to sort of do demos and stuff. And I was like, and like a ranger producer boy was like, what are you going to do with them? I was getting too excited. I was a bit too full on. I think I freaked you out.
No, not at all.
But I want to know about going from, I guess, playing and touring thrash metal to then recording and then touring Beware of the Dogs.
So I toured after the EP for about a solid year and a half without kind of coming home, and I toured solo, and I actually feel like part of the reason I decided to have a band on the record was that I wouldn't be lonely anymore. Is that a valid reason?
That is more than valid, because
sorry to cut you off, crazy.
I would see you touring and I'd be just like, I can't handle touring with my best friends, let alone being alone. That's a great reason.
Yeah, so that was one of the reasons. And I mean, I put half the songs on the record are solo, and then half of them are, you know, a bit more, I've kind of, you know, instrumentalized them a bit more to tell the story. And I guess for me, the difference was that I had zero resources when I recorded the EP. I recorded it on a Squire guitar,
into a cassette?
No, it came out on cassette tape. Okay. We recorded it on a laptop, and it just kind of, I had no idea what the industry was. You know, I'm living in Perth. There's no infrastructure there in terms of like a label scout or anything like that. So it was a whole different experience going into the record and actually being able to, I'd saved up some money to actually pay my friends, who my best friends are in my band too. And
you pay them?
I do. I pay them what I can, pittance, but anyway.
Yeah.
And they, you know, getting to be able to kind of have that, the access to, like, if I hear a bass line, I can go, hey, play that, Jenny, and whatever. So, yeah, it was a really special, special time for me recording that album.
And then going from, actually, let's go back. So you were saying about, you know, in Western Australia, not another country, but in terms of the industry, it is actually quite hard for bands from Western Australia to kind of make it over to the East Coast and vice versa. Like, there's always a bit of a divide, I find.
But I think there's also a real positive thing to being in WA is that you're kind of left to your own devices for a while. And I feel like for me, I played in Perth for 10 years in various different bands and stuff before putting out my own music. And I feel like if I'd been over here or in Sydney or wherever, I might have been maybe like pulled into the kind of more commercial or industry scene earlier than I needed to be, like prematurely.
Poached by the kind of that side of things.
Yeah, so I feel like there's a definite magic in Western Australia, particularly Fremantle where I live, and there's a bunch of beautiful, beautiful bands, and I think the world has its eye on Fremantle for music, and I'm just really lucky to be part of that. Yeah,
I think Fremantle's the new Melbourne, in my opinion. Oh. There seems to be so much good music. Well, just Western Australia in general, there seems to be so much good music coming out of there. Mm. There's so many great players. I mean, even just through you, the connections I've made, you know, there's so many great players, and through them you meet people, and
it's kind of like... we've all had so long to practice, because no one gives a shit.
You've all, you've had 10 years of playing Barnsley songs at weddings.
Yeah, that's it,
That's it. I mean, people always ask us, they're always like, why did it take so long to get your first album out? And it's like, because we weren't good enough.
No, exactly.
It takes a long time to play and
be confident.
You don't
just, like, pop out, like, I'm really good. I'm really good at music.
Well, you probably do.
Absolutely. Hey, apparently you've got some old footage of me singing.
But yeah, but it's good.
You warned me about.
Yeah, well, it's still good, though.
Oh, my God. Yeah.
Mm.
Scary.
We had some fan questions actually that was submitted before the show, which is exciting. Hello everyone, by the way. Hi Alicia, I saw your comment before. I want you guys at Blues Fest. Well, we won't be there this year. Are you?
No, not this. No,
you're going to be at Splendor though this year.
Yes, I'll be at Splendor. Yeah.
So get along to that. Fan questions from Hannah Carly Shields. She says, hi Stella, big fan of your music. Have seen you perform 3 times over the last 8 months, and I'm wondering if you've read any good books lately.
Yeah, I'm actually reading a kid's book that I'm really hooked on, and I never got onto it when I was a kid. I think they made it.
Have you heard of this book called Harry Potter?
Yeah,
I just discovered
it. Well, it's not too far off, actually. Yeah. It's called His Dark Materials, and I think there's a new show about it. I think there's like a new TV show, but anyway, I'm on to like book 5 or something, and I just, it's like the best book to pass the time. And
it's like
I'm
a novel,
27
though.
Year old woman. Yeah, like,
sorry,
as
I thought,
in like this
picture
thing.
Book, like,
although don't, you know, picture books are fantastic.
There's there's one called Cicada. There's my friend got me for my birthday. It's a really amazing picture book.
Cool.
Like, I mean, pictures are great for one thing, but just like you go through it and it's like really depressing, and you're like, where is this going? And the end is just magnificent. Oh. It's the best picture book ever.
Beautiful. Cicada.
Yeah. There it's probably not something you would read to children.
No, so I can't read it then. I only read children's books, Brendan. So it's fine. It's all good.
You've got to stop that. there was another one. Wasn't so much.
I don't just read kids' books, by the way. Just want to clarify.
I don't even read books, so I'm struggling to read my own handwriting. Nikki Wick, this is less of a question than it is just a comment for Stella, but Nikki Wick's, best of luck, Stella. If you ever need any art from one of your fans, hit me up. Blessings from Ireland.
Thank you, Nikki. Ireland is one of my favourite places to play.
I thought you were going to say Wales would be.
Well, of course. It's one of. Wales is obviously, you know, Cymru am byth.
Mm.
Wales forever. But, you know, we like the Irish too.
I did plan to learn a bunch of Welsh phrases to impress you, but I didn't get around to it.
Alas, unimpressed.
But, I mean, that's a good segue. Let's talk about, were you born in Wales or?
No, even though it says that I was everywhere, I think maybe something.
Well, let's clear that up now, Stella.
Yeah,
not
born in Wales. I was born here and then moved to Wales when I was a young child. My mum is Welsh and I, there's someone doing a beer pong tournament next door, by the way, and I think there's a few
because it's the long weekend
funnels.
Oh, I didn't even realize. So. Yeah, that makes sense. Yeah,
the boys. Apologies for that. Don't know what's going on there.
Someone said, sorry to interrupt you.
No,
they said, hi Stella, wondering if you like the Skogsgiz. I don't know what that is. I can't read very well.
Let's have a look. What do you feel
it's
like?
Is Skogsgiz or something? Or Skoshies.
Skoshies.
Oh, that's my friend being a smart ass.
What's Skoshies?
It's a long story.
Okay.
I don't want to be dismissive, but it's not interesting to anyone except me and my friend for this in-joke.
Oh,
Skoshies.
How annoying.
Very good, Nick.
Posting an
in-joke
on live Instagram.
How about you get your own show and, you know, post your silly comments on that, mate? All right?
I like this live thing. It's pretty...
Yeah. Well, if you want to get in there and read it, the only reason I don't read it is because...
They're all being mean? No.
No, it's because my eyes aren't very good, so I find it hard to...
Are the Tesco brothers going to play in Madrid anytime soon?
I never know what I can say, so just keep an eye on things. Somebody asked what your favourite venue in Europe to play was.
Oh, that's a great question. I'm going to go as though... kind of the UK is still part of the EU, because when I was there, it still was.
It was obviously. When we were there, and then when we left, it wasn't.
Yeah, it wasn't. Yeah. So I played in a barn in the North Yorkshire Moors, and the barn is called The Barn. No, The Band Room, and it's in Farndale, and you're in the middle of nowhere, and everyone from the surrounding villages comes, and it's BYO, and it's just the most magical thing. We've played there twice now. So yeah, that's probably one of my favourites in the UK /Europe. And then I think my favourite venue in mainland Europe is probably Vera, which is in Groningen. In the Netherlands. Very cool venue.
Yes.
Very lovely people.
I liked Groningen because everyone bought me stroop waffles. So
oh,
I was very happy about that.
Nice.
Yes.
Love
is there anything in those cups, or are you pretending?
I've got the black tea,
and I've got the calming
tea.
Yes, but there is.
Yeah.
Sorry. Yeah, I digress. Anyway, so you moved to Wales as a young.
Yep. Wee lass.
Yep.
And then lived there for a while, and kind of went to Welsh speaking school, and really immersed ourselves in that sort of culture, and I think that really helped me with my music and confidence and those sorts of things. Helped me with my music. I was like 7. Yeah, I was really working on my career at that point. But, you know, I think it
when did you get in? When was your first kind of, you know, when was the moment where you picked up something or started singing or, you know, just beyond just listening to stuff and enjoying it?
Yeah.
When was it? Did you have a moment where you're like, oh, this is, I want to do this or try this?
I think it was when I started busking at the markets when I was about 15, 16.
Back in
Frio? Mum would do, near Queen's Rock, so the Wanneroo markets. Mum would do her food shopping and just leave me in the corner and let me play the guitar for 3 hours sometimes.
What age is this?
I was about 15.
15?
Yeah, but I played guitar since I was about 8, but just kind of taught myself everything and slowly kind of...
Well, I mean, I feel like one thing that gets overlooked from you, which is probably maybe a positive, is because like your music is so good and you're such a good singer, but nobody ever, like, I feel like you get overlooked as a guitar player, and I think you're an amazing guitar player.
Oh.
And at Port Ferry, that's the thing that I was saying to the guys. Oh. I was just like... The voice, the guitar playing, and the song. It's just like the three things.
Oh,
you know what I mean?
Thank
I was just
so
like,
much.
That's why I was so blown away by it.
Jeez.
So, yeah, I mean, I can tell that you've been playing for a while, and you went to that West Australian jazz contemporary
got a lot out of
art
that.
School or whatever. That year was worth it.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. That's cool. What kind of stuff were you doing back then? Like covers or songs about getting grounded?
Like,
and...
Yeah, well, I think I wrote a song about my nan's house called Our Place,
mm-hmm.
which I rhymed place with face, which I actually rhymed plates with plates in like one of my most recent songs. So it's not as if I've improved at all.
I was just about to bring that up.
Yeah, like zero fucking progression.
Where you break all the plates and what?
Yeah, telling your favourite joke where you break all the plates.
Yeah.
Genius.
Writing Homer with Homer. Genius.
Kodak with Kodak.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. But, yeah, so I wrote a bunch of songs, but it was really kind of, I was singing Dear Mr. President by Pink and Love Song by Amiel and, you know, Kiss Me by Sixpence None the Richer and, the crowd pleasers, you know, on a Sunday morning with people trying to get their groceries. They, really wanted to hear Drive by Incubus. And stuff like that.
We're here tomorrow. Did you, and were people stopping and being amazed or?
No, they were giving
me just being modest
pity,
though,
pity coins.
Really?
Yeah, pity coins.
I mean, I saw a video of you 2011, so I don't know how old were you then?
2011, I would have just turned 18.
Okay, 19. Yeah, well, I saw a video from then and I was very impressed and I would have stopped, so.
Well, thank you very much, Brendan. My gosh.
Yeah.
My gosh, I shudder. I shudder at the thought of old footage.
Of me bringing that up when I couldn't be bothered to lean over.
Yeah.
Hello. There's quite a few things have gone by. I feel like...
Okay, should we have a look?
Yeah, because I feel like normally it's not that... people don't send that many questions, but I feel rude not to... you need to play the old fruit market in Glasgow.
Oh, that'd be
venue
fantastic.
Hi, Stella. What was the inspiration behind... Beware of the Dog's album cover.
Cover, yeah, okay. The album cover is, if you haven't seen it, it's a photo of me just kind of sitting. I don't know, I'm just sitting and it's kind of from here up. And I'm kind of holding my face and someone's trying to feed me a bar of soap. And I guess off, you know, going from the EP where I swear a lot on in my music because I just fucking swear a lot as a human being. It's my way of communicating, unfortunately. I was kind of, you know, had been given that kind of like, wash your mouth out, young lady, you know, sort your shit out, young lady. No one said that. But, you know, I was kind of given that,
yeah.
Yeah, that sort of response by certain, you know, elderly people.
Certain so, old-fashioned.
Yeah, certain old-fashioned people. So it was just kind of a bit ways. Of a joke on that. And
yeah.
Yeah.
So well, that was your response to the response.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly. It's a conversation.
I really like the name. I like the song Beware of the Dogs, but I like the name Beware of the Dogs because it's kind of, there's just a visceral quality to it. It brings up so much. Everyone can identify with that because I think at some point in anyone's life they've seen a sign that says Beware the Dogs.
Yes, yes.
So there's the obvious connection to that tactile memory.
Which is
but
kind
then,
of not what I mean, you know?
Yeah. Okay, I'm getting there.
Oh, sorry.
I was just going to say everyone has that connection, but then when you extrapolate from that, I guess the metaphors therein, it's kind of paint your own, like, you know, you can sort of associate a lot of your own things into it.
Mm.
And I'm sure you have a very specific...
not really.
Oh, good.
Yeah,
well, there you go.
So you know, it's kind of...
Colour by numbers,
depends,
use your own.
Yeah, it really depends on the song and kind of, you know, what sort of story I'm telling. But yeah, I, you know, it's definitely targeted at the powers that be.
Yes.
For sure, yeah.
One thing I love about your music, I spoke to Ruby about this, is I find the hardest thing in songwriting is to balance, like, capturing little moments with specificity and then kind of couching them in amongst sort of more generalized comments on something. Mm. And your song, Beware of the Dogs, has all of these great little moments of just sort of like, I love the line that just says, my home, carpet on the stairs, everyone in bed. And it's just like, I don't know why, but that paints such a vivid sort of picture in my head.
Mm.
But then that leads you into the next thing, which, you know, so it kind of opens you up to these commentaries or social commentaries where it's not so, it's just very cleverly done. I'm very impressed by that ability to balance the two things.
Thank you so much. That's so kind. I definitely like to set a scene for someone to kind of be comfortable in before I then... attack.
You want to lead them into the dark,
exactly.
But hold their hand.
A whole sense of security. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Cushion the information, I think, for me has been my best way of communicating, even just verbally, you know, as a woman, as a human, kind of, you know, growing up and stuff like that. I've found that's the best way to get through to someone is actually not by screaming in their face.
Well, you are
quite, the hard way.
I mean... So as impressive as your music is, your onstage banter is just as... I think some of the best, I would say.
Oh, thank you.
Because that's, in my opinion, that's the hardest bit.
Oh.
Playing songs is easy on stage. Mm. Like
connecting with the audience is a really... be a tough thing.
Well, and breaking through that awkwardness of just like, oh, I'm going to say something. Yeah. And there's not an instrument or music to back that. It's just me
behind.
And them. And so I've always, like, that's the most intimidating thing
to me. I think
the
Teskey Brothers do that really well.
I've been practicing it. As I've said many times, I want to do stand-up comedy, and so that's, like, the ultimate, you know, there's no instrument, it's you and a microphone.
That is the hardest job ever.
Yeah.
Stand-up comedy is the hardest job.
Because it's, in a similar way, I see the two art form, like, in the same way as you can take something and kind of, not just make a comment on it that like 90% of the population can. You can find something in it that's interesting and presents it in a different way, and everyone goes, oh. And so, like, when a good comedian does that, it's a similar thing.
Yeah, it's an education tool, I think, humour. And but I guess I'm lucky because if the joke dies in the ass, I can just start playing the next song and hope that I'm forgiven, you know?
Yeah, well, like, musicians definitely have a lot more... people go a lot more easier on musicians being funny than comedians
being
playing music.
True that.
Speaking of which, there's a joke here. Do you want to read that? Don't read ahead, just read it out.
I think there's nothing cooler than being a lone wolf except on the annual wolf picnic and you don't have a... Virtue. Sorry.
You don't have a partner.
You don't have... Oh, sorry, you don't have a partner for the Wolf Wheelbarrow Race. Where's the crickets button? Fucking hell, that was... it was the delivery. It was bleak. It was a bleak delivery. I apologise.
These are the kind of things I find funny.
For the Wolf Wheelbarrow Race. I get it now.
Yeah, yeah, because you don't have a partner.
Oh, this was me when I played solo and I needed a band so that I could do the Wolf Wheelbarrow Race.
And look, you know, hanging out with your manager's cool, but, you know, after four tours, you kind of want to get some contemporaries.
Absolutely.
And some peers.
Shout out, Phil. Love you.
Phil, he is great. Last time I saw Phil, he was on stage with John Butler in a chicken suit.
In a chicken suit.
Yeah.
That says enough, really. Yeah.
What a man. All right, let's go. But there's great questions coming through here. Can you recommend a Tesco Buzzer song to play at our wedding in September? I don't know. Maybe Stella can. I can recommend Stella's song.
None of my songs.
No, no, no. What's a good song to play at a wedding, one of yours?
Fuck. I don't write any love songs except Mosquito, where I talk about using my vibrator. So...
Tuesday afternoon. Yeah.
Good luck on that one.
Yeah, well, that's there you go. Use that one. will we ever hear a co-write between the Teskey Brothers and Stella?
The night is young.
It
you
certainly
know?
Is. But yeah. I get the impression, now I don't know the answer to this, but I get the impression that your lyrics, I reckon musically we could definitely just like get on a kit and some things or whatever, but I reckon lyrically you're probably... There seems to be so much intention and meaning and such a personal, like, application to your songs that I feel like you wouldn't appreciate a co-write situation.
I've never done one, and it's a really scary thing. I like to think that I'm a very open and collaborative person in everyday life.
I love to connect with people on social.
Yeah, but I think when it comes to writing lyrics, I kind of go into a grumpy state in a way. And Marcel, my partner, who's in the other room, probably watching this live. Hi, Marcel. He kind of can see if I'm ever writing anything. He's like, whoa.
Yeah, just leave her alone.
Cup of tea, love! Yeah, kind of thing. I don't know. It's probably the only time where I get actually really bullish and elbows out. Sorry.
No, that's fine. Okay? Yeah. I'm similar. Yeah, musically, I can do anything.
Yeah.
That sounded really pretentious, but I'm happy to do anything musically with people. Yeah. You know what I mean? If you were like, oh, do you want to come play piano?
Absolutely.
Whereas it was like, oh, I want to help you write that song you're working on at the moment. I'm working on a song at the moment.
Yeah.
And if you were like, oh, I got a good line for that, I'd just be like, keep your line to yourself, mate.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't know.
Turn around, mate.
I shouldn't be like that because there's a lot of amazing writers out there.
I probably have better songs if I let people in, to be honest. So
that's something that was a big lesson for me on the second album was our first album was so insular and we did everything. Mm. Like I produced it, Sam engineered it, we mixed it, mastered it, everything ourselves. Mm. And I'm really proud of it. But the second one came along and I was like, I'm going to let go of the reins and my own ego. And then we invited someone else in to produce and...
It's really important to be open.
Well, it was just a big lesson for me that was like, wow, like,
that's amazing.
You know, things can happen when you're open to them. So maybe I need to reassess.
Totally.
All right, by the end of this, we're going to have a song together.
Yes.
All right, what else have we got here? Loves you in Amsterdam. Go back to Amsterdam soon. We'll be there. Is there anything in those cups? Oh, that was my mum that asked that.
Oh, what's your mum's name?
Sharon.
Hi, Sharon.
You need to... Okay. Album cover. Congratulations for sharing all of these with your fans. Here we go. Here's a good one. Hey, guys. Should we wait for you in Moscow? Russian audience. Let's focus on Stella, people. I mean, I love the questions and the enthusiasm, but we've got Stella who's taken... I like your shirt, Brandon. Thanks, Nadine.
Yeah.
It's just a green one.
It's a great shirt.
Oh, thanks. Stella, your love is in the air like a virgin was so precious.
Aww, that's a song you can play at your
friends
wedding.
Dance to it all the time at school. What a great segue.
Aww,
because
thank
you know
you.
What? I'm going to say something that, you know, I'll probably get yelled at for saying.
Here we go.
But, like, I'm just not a fan of like a virgin. Mm. I'm sick of it.
Mm-hmm.
I just think it gets gimmicky.
Yep.
People don't spend time on the arrangements, and it just becomes this thing of, like, oh, a famous artist is doing this cover. And it's like... Yeah, that's cool, but where's the substance in it? And the reason I'm saying this is because for the first time in a long time, my faith was restored because I saw your one. And I went, that is a great arrangement and a great performance of that song. And there was no gimmicks involved. Mm. It was just, you know what I mean?
I'd like to, I completely think that you're valid in those thoughts because it is literally doing like a version is like jumping into a shark tank. In terms of the way that people comment on
you. The comments get nasty, don't they?
It's a really... I walked into that studio that day, and this is saying nothing on Triple J. This is not, you know, I'm not blaming anyone in particular, but I walked into that studio that day with the thought in the back of my mind that if this goes wrong, my career in Australia to the younger Triple J audience could be over. And I think that was... For an artist to be, for the biggest radio station that's, you know, supporting independent music in Australia, to for that to be a feeling that an artist walks into that with is really fucking devastating. And, you know, I've been part of, you know, NPR, Tiny Desk, I've done KEXP over in the States and stuff like that. And, you know, you get your YouTube comments where people are anonymous and they comment on your body or whatever it is, you know, shut up, bitch, whatever.
Oh, it's fucked.
But Triple J, for people to have their name and their photo of who they are, their actual person, their profile, to just blatantly, to think that they can just pull artists apart and is just... abhorrent. It's disgusting. And part of me wants all the artists to go on strike from like a version until
that
changes.
I would love that.
Because
yes.
I've watched my fellow female artists and many other artists be literally kind of pulled apart in the public sphere. And it's just bullshit. I just think it's bullshit. And we need to do better as a country. In that respect.
I agree.
Yeah, sorry,
Got
a bit heavy there, I feel really strongly about it. So I'm glad you brought it up.
Don't be sorry about it because it's such a valid thing. And the way I see, particularly that audience, and again, I'll probably get in trouble for this, but fuck it. Like, I don't know what it is about that demographic that kind of has this, like, just... the way that they talk about people so crudely, and I've seen it with our friends and, you know, like it's the music industry, but we're all friends. So when you read a nasty comment, it's just like, what the, you know, I do not get it whatsoever.
Yeah.
If you don't like something, just don't like it.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah,
is that totally. That so hard? Like, I just...
Yeah, I just think, I don't know if people realise that the artists actually do read the comments. You know, like, I do. Don't tell me not to read the comments because I'm always going to... It's like...
This guy doesn't because he's scared.
That's fine. Yeah. And I completely understand. But I also, you know, there's that whole thing about comparing artists with each other. You know, I only ever get compared to female artists. I never get kind of, you know... I get put up against fellow female artists in this country and who are friends of mine, and I just think it's crazy.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Well, not to put you against another fellow female artist, but another thing I was going to say, it was your Like a Version and G Flip's Like a Version were two that I watched that were like, yes.
How cool was that?
Yeah.
That was a really special... exciting thing.
It was really
I loved
cool.
watching that. I loved Alex the Astronaut on the cowbell. That was
I didn't even realize it was her till the end.
I could also see her counting going,
yeah.
So
but, you know, it's very important. You don't want to get that cowbell wrong.
The cowbell, especially in that song, very important.
And like also just G Flip, just smashing it on the drums.
Yeah.
Like, she's such a great player.
Huge.
Just like, I can get a beat going, but to sing and play, forget
to
about
sing
it.
And to be kind of like aware of the whole, you know, essentially orchestra that she
pretty
had
much,
in that room was really cool.
It was very impressive.
Yeah.
But yeah, so that was somebody, you know, but...
We got heavy.
Yeah. Well,
sorry.
No, not really. It's not heavy at all. Love from India. There you go.
Hey, thank you.
Love from Nigeria.
Wow. Thank you so much.
When can we expect a tour for India? I don't know.
I would love that.
Yeah.
I would absolutely love that.
So would
that.
I wouldn't even know who to call to make that happen.
I know a really cool Indian agent, and he came to WA recently.
Oh, wow.
And I've got to remember his name, but he was awesome, and he takes bands out through India and goes on tours out there.
Okay.
I must remember his name. He was awesome. We were on a panel together.
Yeah, well.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry I said boring before then. That actually sounded good.
Yeah, yeah.
Is that the panel thing you're on, the manager's thing? Or?
Oh, no, different panel. Oh,
okay.
Yeah.
I stand by my boring
panels point. A lot. It's weird.
Hello, everyone from all around the world. Who are your favourite comedians? That's a good one.
That's
from
a great
me
one.
Personally. Who? What about you? First?
My favourite one is James Acaster. I feel like he's able to be really, really, really funny without offending anyone. He doesn't go for that cheap thing of like targeting a minority to get a kick out of, you know, to get an easy laugh. I think he's really creative. If anything, it's a one-man play. But yeah, I think his work is so fucking funny.
There's something to be said about that, like, kicking down thing.
Yeah.
Like, there's nothing funny about the kicking down thing.
Yeah, at all. Yeah.
And also crude, like, being crude for the sake of crude just doesn't interest me at all.
No.
It's just like, yeah, there's got to be a punch. No. It's just like, there's got to be a punchline in there somewhere. No, I mean
crude. Yeah,
like,
yeah,
you know,
yeah,
you watch some
totally.
Comedians and it's just like, is there a punchline in there?
No, no.
Or is it just, like, filthy words?
He just wanted to say twat a few times, you know? Well, who's your favourite comedian?
Norm MacDonald.
Okay, cool. Yeah. I'm going to write that down.
He's kind of like, yeah, you can
do
write
you use
down.
That all, no. Do you use that with every artist? It's the wolf joke. Speaking of comedians.
No, I just wrote that. To,
oh,
like, you were
beautiful.
There when I was writing that for you.
Norm MacDonald.
Hi from Tassie. Hello. Oh, here we go. What's your favourite karaoke song? What's your go-to?
Oh. It was Thank You by Dido. And then we actually performed it as a cover at Laneway, so I can't really have it anymore.
You know, that song is like my go-to. You're in Coles at 1 in the afternoon, really depressed, and that comes on, and you're just like, is there anything else that could go wrong in my life? You know, it's just like,
hey.
I want to thank you. Just like, pushing your trolley.
I know, but that song is about everything going wrong in your day.
Yeah, I know.
You know?
Yeah.
Your tea's gone cold, you're wondering why, you got out of bed at all.
Yeah.
I'm not going to carry on
I'm much more
song.
Of a Limp Bizkit ilk, you know?
Fair.
Just one of those days when you don't want to wake up. Same thing. You know?
What's your favourite karaoke song?
My go-to is Kiss from a Rose by Seal.
Amazing.
Bye, yeah, 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 yeah. That was good. You've
scary.
Done this before.
I was decided to harmonise with the Teskey brother. That was that was a risk.
Very excited about Lowlands, yes. What's your favourite band name going around it?
Private Function. That's my favourite band name right now.
Yeah.
I haven't heard their music yet. I want to check them out.
Liam's always got funny ones. Like, I'm just so out of the loop. I'm always the last to know about everything. Yeah, next week I think we might have Liam on. So he's got a whole bunch of really funny ones that he knows. Amel and the Sniffers always makes
That's
me laugh.
Great. I love Amel and the Sniffers.
Yeah. I'm so glad they won Best Rock Album at the ARIAs.
100% deserving.
Yeah, it was awesome.
Yeah.
How was the ARIAs, by the way? You were there. We didn't really get to talk much.
Hello. We didn't get to talk much because you were doing, like, on stage, you were getting awards, you were doing everything. No wonder we didn't get
Enough
to talk
about
much.
Me. No, you were busy chatting to your parents.
Yes.
Flew over from WA.
I had my mum and dad with me.
Yeah.
The ARIAs was scary, exciting. I was overstimulated. It was like walking into... like a baseball match where they've got the fireworks and everything happening. I just think I was just like pushed into my seat and just kind of silent with my mum and daddy beside of me, kind of doing the same thing.
Yeah, yeah.
But it was a special time. It was great to see you boys play.
Oh.
I thought that was well, not you boys. Sorry, you had weren't just boys up on stage that night.
True, sure, Charlie was up there.
Yeah, Charlie was up there. I thought that was a really special. That was one of my highlights, actually, was seeing you guys.
Oh,
honestly,
thank you.
No word of a lie.
No,
yeah.
Thank you. No,
so
it means a lot.
For that, it was really great.
Yeah. Were you sort of like, Mum, it's not like this. The music industry isn't always like this.
No, it was really, it was a kind of eye-opening for all three of us, really.
Yeah,
Yeah. I felt like Babe, Pig in the City, you know?
Yeah. I don't know how I felt like. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know. But anyway.
Yeah.
We can all agree that it was very full on.
Yes, yeah.
And how many times did you have to repeat the phrase, it's just nice to be nominated?
Yes.
In interviews? Like, because you know you do all the interviews beforehand.
Yeah,
you don't
want
to be pretentious
of course,
and be like, I'm going to take
I'm
this out.
Winning. No, yeah, I had Tones and I in my category.
It's just
I had
such
no
a,
chance.
Such a, yeah, and you're not, yeah.
She did amazing.
She did do amazing.
Yeah.
Well deserved.
Yeah.
I was going to say something, but I stopped myself.
Yeah, no, she's great.
She is great. What was I saying? Red carpet. Oh, whatever.
Oh, I met the Wiggles.
Oh, yeah.
At the Arias, and I was so excited.
Do you have a favourite Wiggle?
Anthony Wiggle is my absolute favourite. He's so nice. He plays the bagpipes. He's fantastic. He's such a cool guy, and he actually really reaches out to Australian musicians and Australian artists and stuff like that. So
yeah, he was super lovely Anthony, to us as well.
Yeah, he's a legend. Yeah. My parents bought me a blue Wiggle shirt for Christmas.
Oh, really? Yeah. What, like this year or?
Yes.
Oh, wow. Skivvy as well?
No, just the shirt. Oh, okay. Took them ages to find it, actually.
Yeah. Oh, like an actual Wiggles merchandise.
Yeah, like with the Wiggles on it and everything. Not just a blue shirt.
Maybe we have to go to the ABC shop for that.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't know what you call it, manager, assistant manager? Mm-hmm. Al. Yes. My friend that works with us, she loves Human Nature.
Oh,
she
was
so excited, because we were sitting next to them.
Of course.
She was so excited to be there with them.
That was cool. Hall of Fame inductees. Yeah.
How was the performance, too?
Very cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, loved it.
All right, I want to move into a bit of word association.
Okay.
Hang on. Normally there's this thing's not working properly. Hang on.
Word association with Brandon.
There we go. You ready?
Yeah.
I just want snappy answers.
Okay.
No cleverness.
Okay.
Just first thing.
All right.
Accept.
Unts.
That was someone's answer last week.
Really?
Yeah. That's funny. Poison.
Ivy. Ooh.
Watermelon.
Seeds.
Axe.
Girl. Good band from WA.
Dog.
Bone.
Star.
Struck.
Process.
Elimination.
Easter.
Egg.
Pride.
Week.
Tree.
House.
Mother.
Fucking lovely day. Lovely day.
Ink.
Blot.
Sin.
Full.
Bubble.
Bath. Word association
with Brandon.
Was that really normal?
I'm going to be honest with you. I was really impressed with that.
Really?
Because your answers were super quick, and it tells me that you have a very creative mind, but also a very visual. Do you think more in pictures?
Yes, definitely. Yeah. I do cryptic crosswords every day.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So
yeah,
this kind of thing, it's like you have to be able to, like, elaborate and extend on things.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's fun.
Most people freeze up and it's like, but you were, like, straight out. And with good, and the associations are very, let's not get into the psychology.
I feel like I deserve a gold star.
Yeah. I don't know what to give. I don't know. We'll find something for you.
Yeah, I get a pat with Clarice, maybe. Yeah.
Oh, Clarice. Eventually. Clarice is here for all those people that are always asking for more Clarice content. She's just down there, sort of. What's she doing? She's supervising.
She's so sad.
She's the show producer.
Yeah.
Die was cool as well. It was.
Oh, thanks.
This is always awkward. People tell me this is the awkward bit because I'm trying to read.
Yeah, totally.
Well. Should have done time after time for you like a version, but she already did that. You know,
true.
You did that.
True.
You gotta move on.
I'll write that down though, and I'll go back in time.
Yeah, what you should have done.
Yeah.
Hi from Tassie. Hi from Holland.
Hi.
I'd compare Sarah with people like Kelly Phelps or, I don't know what that is.
That's all right. I get called Sarah all the time.
Oh, Stella. My name's Stella, not Sarah. Yeah. Actually, while I'm over here, let's just... Brendan Love and the Not So Late Show is proud to endorse Jennifer Aslett.
She's my bass player.
Bass player of the Stella Donnelly band and also many other things around Western Australia. But one of the latest endorsees. No, endorse... Whatever it is.
Yeah, endorsees. That works.
Yeah.
Of the strings.
Yeah. Well, no, because I'm now endorsing artists secretly.
Oh.
Yeah. I can hook you up.
That'd be sick.
What were your top choices that didn't make it for Like a Version?
Oh, I wanted to play You're Beautiful by Little Birdie. You're beautiful, you're beautiful.
All I've got on my head is, you're beautiful.
No James Blunt here. I really wanted to play that because Little Birdie's a WA band. They absolutely smashed it. I feel like it would have been a real, like, tip of the hat to them. But I was really stoked to be able to play an Australian song still, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think that's I mean, to go back on what I said, I think the one cool thing about Like a Virgin is when it does afford other Australian bands to get a bit of exposure that maybe you might not necessarily get it on
Triple
J.
Totally. And look, yeah, I'm very grateful to Triple J for supporting and, you know, championing my music.
I can say whatever I want because they don't support us.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Well, they don't. They've never played
us. Yeah.
Hi, my sponsor. Oh, hello. There you go.
Is that Jenny?
Yeah, call in, Jenny.
Oh, call in. We need the weather from Perth.
Yeah. Oh, actually, hang on. We need to do the weather. Hang on. Wait.
If that way.
No. So that was the weather. All right, let's go into another segment. You ready for this one?
Yeah.
No. If you only knew the things I'd ask you, a segment on my show, something, something, something. If you only knew.
Slightly embarrassed with the level of effort I go to.
It's beautiful.
You ready for this?
Yeah.
Okay. Childhood celebrity crush.
Oh. I actually think I had a crush on Arthur, which is actually a cartoon.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Is that, hey, a wonderful time.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a good one.
It's a bit weird.
Yeah, no, I had a crush on Ickes.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Nice.
Biggest risk you've ever taken?
I sent a group email with everyone on CC. This is before I had a manager. I was self-managed for a while. Like, as in all the publishers and labels and agents who had kind of reached out to me when I first put out my EP, I sent them all an email saying, hey, I'm playing a gig tonight in Sydney. Come and decide if you actually like my music. Love, Stella. And, like, all these opposing forces of people came to the gig. It was a bit of a fucking risk.
But that's good for you, though.
It was great for me, but it was...
Play these vultures off against each other.
It paid off, but it was, like, a bit of a rookie thing to do.
No, that's
probably not the biggest risk, but it's the first thing I thought of.
That's fine.
Yeah.
Something you wish you were better at?
Drawing.
Yeah, okay.
Public interviews.
You're great at them.
I wish I was more eloquent.
No, I think you're endearing yourself to the... You know, Teskey Brothers fans. And there's quite a lot of Stella fans on here too.
Oh, thank you.
Someone just said they really love your music, Stella.
Oh, so. Thank you so much.
There you go. Los Angeles, mate.
Hey.
Soon. I don't know. Or you. You're going there soon.
I hopefully am, yeah, in June. But it hasn't been announced yet. Shush.
Oh, sorry. Speaking of emails with the wrong thing.
Yeah, exactly.
What do you sing in the shower?
Probably Missy Higgins.
Which song?
The Specialty.
Okay, I love Missy Higgins. Oh, I shouldn't say that. I'll tell you off air.
Okay.
But I really want to get her on the show.
Oh.
But I've been a bit like, not embarrassed, but
she would love this.
Well,
I mean, I can't speak for Missy, but I feel like this would be her vibe.
Well,
she would love this.
Well, I'd love to get
her. Don't sell yourself short. What's next?
Okay. Sorry. You're getting bored.
Hungry.
Sorry.
I'm joking. No,
that's true, though.
I've
come right in the middle of dinner. Characteristic you value most in others?
Honesty. Even if the truth is a bit awkward or if the truth isn't convenient, I'd much prefer someone to be like, hey, I'm an anxious person, or hey, I don't like to speak a lot, you know, or whatever. I prefer that than them have to fake it. I hope that I'm that person for someone, you know?
Yeah. I'm honest to my detriment. It gets me in trouble. But I think in the long run, it doesn't.
It's worth it. Absolutely. Yeah.
What do you value most in yourself?
My willingness. I've only just learnt this last week, is that I'm someone who's willing to have tough conversations.
Okay.
I feel like my music is a tough conversation at times for people, but I kind of thrive on... Like, actually kind of, if, you know, something's up, I thrive on, like, getting in there and, like having the tough conversation and not letting it boil over for, like, months and months and months. It's got me into so much trouble, but it's something that I will continue to do.
But that's kind of like the forest fire coming through, isn't it?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You've got to burn off the stuff to let the new growth come through.
Yeah.
This is not even the segment, but as you said that, it made me think. I read a quote from you, and someone asked you what characteristic do you think is overrated, and you said meekness.
I think I was put on the spot.
Okay.
Be whatever you need.
I just found that
interesting,
and I was gonna bloviate about Nietzsche, but never mind.
I wouldn't. I'm sorry.
No, it's fine. I'll talk about it with Missy.
She'll give you a better.
She's more well versed in philosophy than Nietzsche.
Exactly. Yeah.
Do you have a favorite joke?
Oh, yeah. Can't say it though.
Too rude.
It's just. Yeah, I don't know. It's rude. People think it's. I've never really gotten many laughs. My dad and I think it's really funny.
Oh, I'm
just gonna say it.
Yeah, go.
It's
on.
Not offensive at all.
Yeah,
other
go
than
on.
A little. It's a little bit, but like it's what's black and red and sits in a tree, a crow with a stiffy. That's all. It's fucked. It's stupid. My dad pretends that it's in the Christmas cracker every Christmas. He pretends that that's what's been written down.
What a jokester.
And people are like, oh my God.
I like him already. What makes you angry?
Oh, God.
Just, we've only got 10 minutes left here.
So. far out. No, I. Yeah, a lot of things, really.
Me?
No, not at all.
Having to do this stupid TV show while my couscous is getting cold.
Not my couscous.
Yeah.
No, honestly, a lot of things make me angry, but mostly myself.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's a lame question.
That's all right.
No, I got to get rid of that one. I hate that one. People always ask that.
Oh, yeah.
What's something that you used to hold to be true and have had your mind changed?
I think what we were talking about before is that openness to collaboration and that sort of thing. I mean, I think I'll always be pretty tight with my lyrics and that sort of thing. But in terms of musical collaboration, I feel like I used to think it was just like, don't let anyone in, you know. But now, I mean, it's impossible to be able to carry a career on your own, you know. Maybe you can, but for me, I'd like to be open to the fact that people could collaborate with me, even if I end up going nah. I just want to kind of let myself be open to that in the future. So
Well, I mean, you've got my number. I've got 4 months off.
Yeah, beautiful.
Before we go, I really wanted to, so our tour manager is Welsh.
Tom. Tom, yes, I've met Tom.
He's actually in Australia at the moment.
Aww.
He's probably not watching. But and our stage manager is also Welsh.
Yes.
And they were speaking Welsh.
Yes, Siarad Cymraeg.
Yeah, right. And Welsh. So they're chatting away and I'm just like, they're having me on. And there was one word that particularly took my fancy.
Yep.
I can't remember, you'll know, but the word for microwave.
Popty ping.
Yeah. They were like, saying all this stuff and then popty ping. And I'm like, you guys are just making it up.
It's sad because it's a new Welsh word.
Yeah,
obviously microwaves weren't around when the ancient Celtic language, you know, was kind of made. But I love it. It's a great word. Jellyfish is.
Oh yeah, this is a good one.
Pascod wibbly wobbly.
Yeah,
so pascod is fish. Wibbly wobbly.
I did look up, I looked up a bunch of stuff to impress you, but I just forgot it. But I thought what could be fun just before we go is I've heard a bunch of phrases in Wales.
Oh.
And I was wondering if I played them to you, you could translate them.
Oh, fuck, probably not.
Well, we'll give it a go.
I'm really bad. It's going to be bad.
Do you get it?
Oh, it's a whale.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a whale.
Do you get it?
Oh my gosh, Clarice just did this little thing.
Maybe she knows what it is. Maybe Clarice knows Wales. She speaks English.
Aw, Clarice, have you done your tax return yet?
Okay, Clarice, where's Einstein's pants?
Ears went up.
Look at that.
Beautiful.
Where's Einstein's pants? Anyway, nobody knows what I'm talking about.
My friend
about.
Has a baby that will only respond to you if you speak to it in a regular adult voice.
I refuse to speak to children in baby
in
voice.
Baby voice.
No matter what the age,
yeah.
I can't do baby voice because I feel like it creates a feedback loop.
Oh, totally.
Because then they start talking with these affectations and they go, I'm not sure children sound like that.
Totally.
I think they're just playing back everyone being like, ooh.
Yeah, exactly.
Anyway. Such an angry man. Do you enjoy a shower beer? I don't drink, do you?
No, I don't drink very much either.
Okay.
Yeah. I like a shower water. Just,
Yeah, I used to do that when I was little. It always just to make me feel a bit sick.
Yeah,
something about
true.
The. Hey, do you find that, I always used to argue about this with an ex of long ago, but like sometimes we'd be sitting there like, can you get me some water? And you get me some water? And we'd argue about who would get each other the water. Yeah. And eventually sometimes she'd cave in and get me water and be like, yes! But she'd go to the bathroom because it was closer and fill it up out of the bathroom tap. I could always taste the difference between bathroom tap water and kitchen tap water.
Yeah, interesting. Yeah, I think that's real. We need to stop talking about water because I need to wee.
Right. Well, we're going to go soon.
I should have weed before. It's the tea. Oh my gosh. Sorry. That's so unprofessional.
No, that's good. Well,
I
think we should wrap it up anyway.
Is everyone being mean?
No, everyone's being lovely.
Oh, that's everyone nice. Loves you. Don't do baby talk.
I'm going to be honest with you.
Message,
I didn't know Wales had its own language.
Yeah, well, there you go.
Yeah.
And it's actually one of the most ancient languages in the world, and it is to be celebrated.
And
just like
actually,
the word Poptiping. We've got the longest word in the world.
They do, the train stations.
Llangfair, Pwllgwyngyll, Gogerill, Fundisiniar, Chwyndrobych, Gogogoch. If that's not going to get you likes, I don't know what will.
Yeah, I know. And also, if you see that, go look that up. Look up how that's spelled.
Yeah.
The longest word in Welsh is a train station. Mm. There is not one vowel. It's all consonants.
It's all consonants. The Irish took all the vowels. They've got lots of vowels in their language. And they took all the consonants.
Is that like your
dad's...
It was
a deal. It was a deal that was struck, you know? Thank you.
Oh, wait. No, this is more appropriate.
I can't win.
Tell them what you got coming up because I didn't look up your gigs.
I've got the Seed concert this Wednesday night, and then I've got a bunch of time off, which for me is a pretty big thing. But I'm playing Splendor in the Grass in July this year, and we'll see.
What are you planning to do on your time off?
Write songs, hopefully.
For next album? Or just...
Hopefully, yeah. Just sort of take it easy. Yeah.
Well, that's good. Time off is good. I've got time off and, this is the result of it. So.
Yeah. Beautiful.
85 characters. Wow. Longest place name is actually in New Zealand. It's a Māori word.
Oh.
I would love to know what it is.
Yeah, please tell us.
If you can send us what the word is.
Yeah.
The
Welsh just, you know...
Yeah. Next time you're in Calais. Anyway, we can you sing something? Sing something together.
Okay.
No, we got 3 minutes left and I can't come up with anything before then. So, thank you all for watching. Thanks, Stella, for coming on
and allowing us
to broadcast from her, not her home, but wherever she's crashing in Melbourne at the moment. Yeah, the squat. Anyway, thanks again, everybody.
Thank you. Nice to meet you all.
Oh no! Here we go! Alright, thank you!
That's life!
Somebody said name the other one sound of the whales.
That's what all the people say!
That's great!
Yeah.
You're
I'm
riding
gonna wait! I'm busting!
That's it!